The MiG has you in his gun sight. What were you thinking at this point? Makes an aggressive vertical move here, comes over the top, and he defeats the bandit with a missile shot. The encounter was a victory. Next.
It is very tempting to try to pick up a target that shows up on the radar momentarily or shows up on AWACS. It's all about just balancing out what you're doing and who you are going to engage. Sometimes it's worth it, sometimes it's not. One of the key things is to have that situational awareness. Now, I know that I've got a plane at my 12 o'clock. I can get a beat on him, but by this point, I'm also checking the radar, and John Connor has now engaged me, and he is coming my way. He has me on radar. I pick him up as well, and I fire off a missile. Now, he banks, and he fires an AIM-120. What I do here is I'm bouncing around the mountain, and I do get a kill there. I did have to get out of the way real quick here because that missile was coming my way, and I just said, okay, you know what? I got to get out of there. At this point, I have plenty of targets. I can't pick up all of them because some of them are fairly low. Also, I can see that there's quite a bit of traffic to the north of red planes coming in that are on my side, and this is where it gets a little tricky, so I'm trying to pick up an available target that I can engage. And at this point, all I've got is R-73s, which are short-range Sidewinder-type missiles. Got to be conservative. But it's really key to watch your missiles, watch your fuel. I have been very conservative with my fuel. There are missiles flying around like crazy. As you can see, Riley is on my 12 o'clock right now. I pick him up, and then I disengage because I do see that he is active. But check the map all the time. I don't want to turn my radar on to get IFF. There's another plane, which is Science. He's breaking low and heading away from me towards the east. But there are a few other targets nearby as well. Fairly hot battle happening. And it's just a matter of just staying in those valleys and keeping an eye on what's going on. Again, banking away because I am picking up radar on me. At the same time, trying to keep an eye on any targets that become available. This is where it's a little tricky because I've got Riley right in front of me, right on my radar, but the last thing I want to do is actually hit him with my missiles. I don't want to turn on my radar as possible to make sure that I don't reveal myself. We've got a Mirage, and we've got, right here, the banking away of Crow 888, or Quadruple 8, or Quintuple 8. He gets an R-73. It's on him. Second R-73, just for good measure. He breaks away. I'm on him. One R-73 doesn't get him. The second one does get him. I don't know if my first one would have hit him or not, but at this point, I am aware that I am being tracked, so I dive for the hills. Interestingly enough, that F5, the lizard, is still over there in the other valley across, but I am not paying attention to him because I've got a lot of traffic. Me popping up like that has definitely raised the hornet's nest. There's Captain BTW that's coming in from the north. There's another guy, Smoothbrain, that's staying up high, and I've got another F-18 that's also coming in. Now, right here, vertical shot. This guy got a little too eager, this F-15, and a couple of missiles at him. One, and he's done. I shouldn't have fired the second missile, but that was for good measure. Immediately, I'm evading, and I know that I've lit myself up on radar. An F-18 is turning towards me, that's Smoothbrain. I am trying to drop low. The other thing that's not helping is also checking the RWR to see if I have any ground-to-air missiles coming at me from the blue base, because I'm basically just hanging out in the blue base territory. Not a fun thing to do. Now, sometimes you do want to get out of there. I've got no missiles left, and I'm thinking of heading home. I've got plenty of fuel to get home, and this is where the video game kicks in, because yeah, it's a video game. My first reaction is right here to bank away and to head for base. I've got clear sky. I probably should have tried maybe to gun down the lizard guy here who's trying to go after the F-14. But I wasn't aware of that. All I could see was that there were aircraft coming up behind me and that I could potentially get one more kill. And I make the decision. I'm like, you know what? This is a video game. I don't care about saving this plane, which I should have done, but I decided to get cocky and to engage another bandit. There are a couple of hostiles around me here. Let's go into vertical view and see what we've got here. So I'm definitely being cocky. This was honestly a mistake. I saw that there were planes taking off from the enemy base. So I'm pushing towards them right now. And I decided, you know what, I've got enough fuel. Maybe I can do a guns engagement. Ridiculous idea. I have to approach these guys. I have to stay low. But I'm hoping that if I stay in this valley long enough, I can get close enough to an enemy plane without being revealed. And as you can see, I'm staying really low in this valley, banking around. And here's Crow quintuplate. Yeah, here he comes. Now, we're at 11 nautical miles. And I think at this point, he picked me up either on RWR or he picked me up through his radar, or somebody told him that Plasma's being a jerk and is flying around here. Now, the problem here is that I decided to approach him. I'm staying low. I'm giving it full gas. I'm actually going supersonic here, staying real low, but he does pick me up. I start picking up his radar. He's already locked onto me. I'm firing guns because I got no missiles. And of course, I eat an AIM-120. So there's your lesson. Don't get cocky. Oh yeah, and that's me falling down and shooting guns as my airplane falls into pieces. And of course, I eject and watch the clouds go by as Crow Quintuplate just heads out on his way. And there's me in my little parachute being sad. So the lesson here is, if you want to have fun, go have fun. But if you want to be a smart pilot, turn around, go back, be conservative with your fuel if we have no missiles, and don't try to be silly. Maybe I could have taken him on in his plane if he had exhausted all his missiles and I was in a position where I could get close enough to him. If we had a dogfight where we could shoot at each other for a bit without actually getting into any trouble and fired off all of our missiles. But at this point, all I got is my parachute. So there you have it, another successful mission, 3 kills, and I'm not going to tell you about the rest of the night because the rest of the night was not very successful. So the best thing I can suggest to everybody is don't get frustrated, stay smart, don't make any silly moves in the game. It is a fun game, but remember, this is a simulator, and have fun. Let me know what you think, and that's me signing off.